So my name is James Brostis. I work for Checkmarx. This talk is going to go over securing your software development lifecycle and talking about kind of a concept of instead of shifting left, more on the idea of shifting everywhere. I am the head of product at Checkmarx, and we have an application security platform that provides security tools throughout the whole software development lifecycle. So the agenda for this talk today is to go over that concept of shifting left to shifting everywhere. So shifting left, it was a very popular marketing term that came out about 5 or 6 years ago with the idea of having developers find and fix vulnerabilities early in the lifecycle instead of after it's being deployed. So while they develop, they're actually getting security results, fixing them before it's actually deployed. And you can just imagine the ROI on top of that, where the faster you find them, the faster you fix them, the less it's going to cost you in the end run. I'm going to also talk to you about the digital transformation demands that come with the new modern technologies. So everything is cloud native architecture. You can think of everything going towards into the cloud. Everything is an application right now. We're shifting everything throughout the software development lifecycle, pushing things from the very beginning to pushing it into production or pre-production and then pushing it into production. It's key that not only are you giving developers security vulnerabilities, but you're also giving them remediation advice while they're programming. It's one thing just to give a developer a security finding, but it's another thing to show them exactly how to fix it, exactly where to fix it, and exactly when to fix it. So as you imagine, everything needs to be very fast. Personally, at Checkmarx, we are doing bug fixes, escalations on a daily basis. We go to production with new features once a week, once every 2 weeks. So you can imagine just everything driving to the cloud really fast. The developers going against competition, you're going to start using open source tools as well. So imagine not only our developers have to worry about the source code they write, but they also have to worry about the source code that they're bringing in. So it's very important to not only consider the fact of the code that they write, but also the open source packages. Everything right now is an API. So how are you securing your APIs? And not only do you have APIs that are being exposed, but you have also your infrastructure as code. So you can think about all the tokens that you might be exposed and also the network traffic that might not be secure. So some of the demands that come with digital transformation is going to be the support for modern development. So you can think of microservices and containers. Everything is a cloud-native deployment. As I mentioned before, API security would probably be my biggest concern. It's not only APIs that are documented through either your documentation or through Swagger, but it's also those shadow APIs that are not even in your Swagger files. So how are you identifying your whole API inventory? Identifying the risks inside your open source packages. So again, I mentioned earlier, all developers are bringing in open source packages. Are these packages secure? How could you trust them? And the key to all of this for security is to integrate it and automate it. It has to be built into your pipeline. It has to be not only scanned during your pipeline, but the results have to come back to the developers inside of their ecosystem. So some evolution you can think of. I'm kind of old school. I come from that waterfall days. But now everything's kind of gone towards more agile. Everything is going towards CI/CD. So not only is it the continuing integration, but it's also the continuous deployment. To me, that's like the key factor, right? How you can get from one end to all the way to the end, all automated. And now bring on top of that is the ability to bring DevSecOps in as well. So everything is an app, OK? And it's very important to remember that I think the new technology, everything, how data works, is using APIs. Everything is connected. All right, so some of the evolution that's happening, you can see frequent and continuing releases. So as I mentioned, like even at Checkmarx itself, we're throwing things into production on a daily basis. You have microservices, open source, containers, the infrastructure as code itself, and APIs. You have multiple deployments, and you're shifting everything to the cloud. So we have three different deployments currently. We use a canary version. We have single tenant. So we have all these different deployments that are in the cloud. And it's all kind of run by DevSecOps. So it's not just the private sector that, you know, is noticing this this evolution, but it's also the public sector. And I saw this quote, and it really kind of hit hard, because we all have an obligation to our customers to do our best to provide a secure application. So it's not just enough to push something out. There's a lot of security concerns that customers have. So to do our best, we have to provide the best solution and try to have the correct fixes that are going in and making sure that our applications are secure. So talking about testing through the software development cycle, to me, when I think about the shifting everywhere concept, it's not just adding new tools. It's not being like, OK, I'm going to add in another scanner during deployment, or I'm going to add another container scanning. It's the idea of bringing different tools to help you get context and help you prioritize. It's actually, by adding more tools in this scenario, you're actually reducing the amount of noise. Because what you can do is you can find out the context of the application and then prioritize those type of findings. The last thing you want the developers is to be overloaded with more security vulnerabilities. That's not what I'm saying at all when I say shift everywhere. When I say with shift everywhere, it's adding more context to your actual results that you are currently giving. So the idea is not only are you giving context, but you're also correlating some of those results. You can think of something that's being done dynamically on your production. You're doing some kind of DAS scanning. How can you correlate it to actual static analysis? And when you do correlate those, then you can actually raise the priority of that. The idea that, you know, we aim for is to actually aim for like the top 10 critical type of vulnerabilities across the whole software development lifecycle. One of the keys to that is to actually correlate those results throughout multiple engines. I love to say whenever I talk to our customers on how you, especially the application security team, is how you actually work with your development team. How are you breaking down those silos? And if you're not familiar with the security champion model, that's the idea of being able to scale out your AppSec team by having, you know, your own kind of agents working in the development team. So each team has a developer dedicated to that security, and they actually work with the teams together. This is a way of scaling it out, and it also builds trust. So you're building basically the program directly from the developers. So that's a key way of actually breaking down silos. I'm a big proponent of the actual security champion model. Integration. So it's so crucial to have this all-in-one platform. That's one of our philosophies here, because then that's how you can actually start correlating these results and actually getting the prioritizing these together. The key to all of this is automation. No one wants to do manual type of scans. You want to have it automated into your pipeline. Not only do you want it automated in your pipeline, but you also want the results being automated, either going to your bug tracking system or going directly back into the pull request decoration. A single dashboard will give you a single point of view, especially if you're on that CISO level or management level. You want to get a good idea how your program is doing. You want to have a one-level report kind of view that you can put together. We talked about correlating all those risks. This is key to everything. If you're adding more tools, you want less noise. And I like to talk about developer education as well. You know, I go to conferences and classes all the time, and to be perfectly honest with you, I forget things almost an hour after I do it. So one of the keys that we think is integrating training into these results. So it's just in time, a 5 to 8 minute type of interactive course that you can put inside of your vulnerability management system, where you can actually have the developers train themselves over and over. So if they forget it, which they're going to, they can easily retake that course to learn how to fix that vulnerability. So this is alignment between AppSec and development. I really think that feedback going into the development, going back to the developers is key, and having that all automated. You're going to want to reduce the number of findings that you actually send to your developers, and it's more correlated. You can do it during training and design and the coding. This is kind of that mentality of actually shifting left. And then you also have it actually, you know, automated during the deployment system. So if you're scanning containers in real-time memory, if you're running DAS, these are all types of things that can be integrated into your SDLC and help you reduce the actual number of vulnerabilities, because you're correlating it with the shift left vulnerabilities that are found. And DevSecOps, of course, is, you know, that's kind of the, you know, the buzzword as well, or it has been a buzzword for a very long time. But it's really kind of reducing that silo, having people work together. I guess the key here is creating culture. So it is a culture shift, and that's why it is important to involve the developers. We see in this AppSec space, it used to be owned directly by the application security team, and they were more seen as police than anything. So with a culture shift, it's really making sure that the developers understand the risk that they're putting inside their applications. When it comes down to it, I truly believe developers want to provide a secure app. They just need to know what's right and what's wrong. And by having the AppSec team be as a guidance or as a counselor, this is the best way to, you know, change that culture and have everyone on the same page. But it has to be driven up from the very top. It has to be a message from the CISO, the CEO, the VP of engineering, whoever it is, everyone has to be on board. So here are some surveys that we did trying to figure out what kind of applications that, or what kind of security tools people are actually using. So you can see that, you know, most people are already using the typical SCA and DAS and SAS scanning, and they're also thinking about adding on more. So what people are looking at right now is improving their API scanning and container scanning. So these are two different aspects that a lot of development teams might not be using, but are planning on adding on in the near future. And it's a concept of shifting everywhere. So it's not only having it done during development, but it's doing pen testing, it's adding it during pre-deployment, it's doing it in deployment as well. So it's not just us saying that it's being shifted everywhere. During our survey, we actually saw people actually agreeing with this kind of our theory here. So one of the key things for Checkmarx that we did, I feel, was kind of make it as frictionless as possible, making it seamless into their integration. So having it inside the developer ecosystem. If we have some kind of finding or we find something, we automatically put a ticket in Jira. Or we decorate the pull request. Or we have IDE plugins. The last thing we want to do, really, is take the developer out of their own ecosystem and bring them into another platform. They have enough platforms to learn. So we want to make sure that we're integrating directly within their own ecosystem. So these are some services that Checkmarx can help you with. We provide application security, SAS's static analysis, software composition analysis, supply chain security, container security, ISA security, and DAS. So we're going from shift left, always shift everywhere with container scanning and dynamic analysis. I really like this last slide here. It kind of shows, you know, what we feel like a philosophy for our company. We have all of our engines, and on top of that, we have a layer called Fusion. Fusion is that key piece that does the correlation. This will help reduce the number of vulnerabilities displayed to developers, but also show you exactly what is important as well. So if you're interested in seeing a demo, we have a booth in the back over there. My name is James Process, and thank you for attending.